Hello everyone, today we will learn new lesson from CBC class 10th English from the book First Flight. The third unit is about two stories about flying, out of which first story today we will learn about the seagull bird. From the title of the lesson, his first flight. The first number story from the third number unit is His First Flight. It is written by Liam O'Flaherty. This is a lesson about the art of flying by a young baby seagull bird. How does he take a first flight into the space? This thing which we will see in this lesson. Before we move into the actual story, let's know something about the author. Liam O'Flaherty was born on 28 August 1896 and he passed away on 7 September 1984. He was born in Ireland. This Irish novelist and short story writer, whose works combine brutal naturalism, psychological analysis, poverty and biting satire with a respect for the courage and persistence of Irish people. Ireland, one of the country from United Kingdom, UK, where the natural calamity is not favorable for the people to live, and in that situation, how he observe and come up with a great man we have to see here. Liam O'Flaherty was considered to be a leading figure of the Irish Renaissance. His books include Thy Neighbor's Wife, 1923 it was published. His successful first novel was The Black Soul, which was published in 1924. The Famine, 1937. His autobiography, Shame the Devil, was published in 1934. So, first of all, we see the introduction of the lesson, His First Flight. The story, His First Flight, is written by Liam O'Flaherty, is an account of a young bird, a baby bird that is afraid to fly for the first time. He believes that his wings would not support him despite his younger siblings flying fearlessly with a much shorter wings. He could not gather his courage to do the same. He was punished to stay hungry for 24 hours and he didn't try for the fly. Thus, it was his mother that compelled him, forced him to fly by using the food as a trap. The lesson reflects how one hesitates to take the first step, and that fear is all in the mind. One should trust one's abilities because the fear of suffering is worse than the suffering itself. So, the story deals with a theme that fearlessness and the courage helps the anyone to achieve the success. Or any art cannot be learned without courage. So in this lesson, there are some characters. They are as follows. Totally, there are six characters in the form of the birds, and it is actually a family of birds, of a family including six members of seagull bird. The first one is baby seagull bird, then father of the seagull bird, mother seagull bird, and his two elder brothers and one younger sisters. So in this picture, you will notice that there are 6 birds, out of which 2 are his parents, 1 is he himself, and 2 are his brothers, and 1 is a sister, younger sister. See, these 6 members involved in act of flying, which they make the baby seagull bird to fly. This, first of all, we see the seagull bird. A young seagull bird who is very young one and afraid to fly for the first time, he is kept hungry for 24 hours as a punishment by the mother. Out of hunger, he falls a prey to his mother's trap by using the food. He makes his first flight in the company of his family members. The second most important character is mother of that baby seagull bird. She is a quite caring mother, supportive and compassionate creature, intelligent and responsible family member. In this lesson, some difficult words will occur. The first one is seagull bird, a bird that lives near the sea and has short legs, long wings, and white and grey feathers. Ledge, a narrow horizontal shell projecting from a wall, or here cliff. Brink, the extreme edge of land. Mustard, gather. Plunk, jump or dive. Upbraiding, scolding. Derisively, a manner expressing the contempt or ridicule. So, next word is plaintively, sad, halted, stopped, herring, soft, thin, sea fish, devour, eat quickly or hurriedly, cackle, laugh at somebody in a loud and harsh way, cowardice, lack of bravery. So, the key points of the lessons will be seen. It is an interesting story of a seagull bird that was afraid to fly. He didn't have the confidence. He was full of pessimism. His parents bothered. His parents, brothers, and his sisters encouraged and scolded, tempted, taunted him to make his first flight, but he could not collect enough courage to fly. He was left alone for 24 hours and he ate nothing. He was extremely hungry. His mother was looking at him. He begged her for food. She picked up a piece of fish and flew across him. The sight of food maddened him. He dived. He cried and screamed. His wings opened up automatically. He flapped his wings. He was joined by his family. In his first flight, his family praised him for his efforts and offered him to scrape off dogfish. So these were the key points from the lessons. Now we will see the lesson in a detail. The story is about a seagull bird who is afraid to fly. He feels that its wings are not strong enough to make it fly. How he overcomes this fear, he tries a new venture, and the story of his successful maiden first flight has been beautifully narrated in this story. So this is a seagull bird who is quite young. This baby seagull bird was alone on the ledge. His two brothers and his younger sister had already flown away the way the day before. He had been afraid to fly with them. Somehow he had taken a little run forward to the brink, the edge of the ledge, that plateau or cliff, and attempted to flap his wings, but he became afraid. Here in this picture you can see rest of the 5 birds. The family members have flown away, but he remained there on the ledge. The great expanse of sea stretched down beneath. It was such a long way down, miles down. He felt certain that wings would never support him. You can see the distance from the top of the ledge to the surface of water is so much, and to see that distance the baby seagull bird is afraid. He failed to muster up, collect his courage to take into the plunge jump, which appeared to him so desperate. His father and mother had come around. His father and mother had come around, calling him shrilly, upbraiding, scolding him, threatening him to let him strive on the ledge unless he flew away. But for the life of him, he could not move. That was 24 hours ago. Since then, nobody had come near to him. All the morning, the whole family had walked about on a big plateau midway down the opposite cliff, taunting him with his crowded eyes, and he pretended to be falling asleep. He stepped slowly out to the brink of ledge, and standing on one leg with the other leg hidden under his wing, he closed one eye and then other. His father was preening the feathers on his white back. Preening means just brushing the feathers. Only his mother was looking at him. She was standing on the little high hump of the plateau. Her white beast thrust forward, came forward. She tore a piece of fish that lay at her feet and then scraped each side of her beak on the rock. The sight of the food maddened the seagull bird. "Ga, ga, ga," he cried, begging her to bring him some food. "Ga, poach," she screamed back derisively, hatefully. His mother had picked up a piece of a fish and was flying across to him with it. But when she was just opposite to him, she halted, she stopped. When her wings motionless, the piece of fish in her beak almost within the reach of his beak, he waited a moment in a surprise, wondering why she didn't come nearer and closer to him. And then, maddened by hunger, he dived at the fish. But with a loud scream, he fell outwards and downwards into the pit. Then a monstrous terror seized him and his heart stood still. The next moment he fell, his wings spread outwards. The wind rushed against his beast feathers, then under his stomach and against his wings. He could feel the tips of his wings cutting through the air. He was not falling headlong now. His father flew over him, screaming. He saw his two brothers and his sisters flying around him, curveting and banking and soaring and diving. His parents and his brothers and his sisters had landed on his green flooring ahead of him. They were beckoning to him, calling him shrilly. He was tired and weak with a hunger and that he could not rise. Exhausted by the strange exercise, he dropped his legs to stand on the green sea. He screamed, he shouted with a fright and fear, attempted to rise again, flapping his wings. His feet sank into the green sea. His feet sank into the green sea, and then his belly, stomach touched to the surface of water, and he sank no further. He was floating on it. So the whole family was screaming, praising him, and their beaks were feeding the scraps, pieces of dogfish. And their beaks were offering him the scraps, pieces of dogfish. His parents and his brothers and sisters had landed on the green floor, that is the surface of water ahead of him, and they were beckoning him, calling him shrilly and encouraging him. And thereby the young, that baby seagull bird, had made his first flight in the pace for his lifetime. So children, now this is the time to conclude. So fearlessness and courage helps to achieve the success, and any art cannot be learned without the courage showed by us. So without venture, success is not possible. Bravery and cowardice are the relative terms. One is cowardice as long as fear encompasses, surrounds him or her. In this story, the young Sigul poses to be a coward, but his parents' encouragement makes him to learn the art of flying. So we can say the parental encouragements and discipline play a great role in the shaping the destiny of the young children. So thereby, children, I hope you understood the lessons. Thank you.